Welcome to Little Falls, population 7,700. Little Falls is a struggling semi-industrial and residential community located along the New York State Thruway at exit 29A, some 60 miles west of the city of Albany. The Mohawk River and its barge canal run right through Little Falls and have in the past been a source of life for the community. At the turn of the century, Little Falls was a thriving community of around 30,000, where river barge traffic stopped with great frequency, where water power turned the wheels of factories providing economic security for the residents of the community, where the promises of growth pointed the way toward a bustling, sound community which would be a financial leader in its region. Since then, however, the truck has taken precedence over the barge and electricity over water power. Increases in population in the large cities have lowered labor costs and material costs in them. Centralization of shipping in them has made small town stops less profitable and benefited the large cities at the expense of the small. Still further, the easy availability of electricity in other regions lured industries away, and Little Falls began an economic decline that has perhaps only now begun to swing upward. Along the Mohawk River, between it and the barge canal, lock number 17, is a small island. The island exists mainly because the canal was dug there to bypass the river falls. When the water rose high enough, however, the piece of land became an island even before the canal was constructed. This island has a rich variety of plants on it, such as northern white cedar, black tupelo, witch hazel, oaks, mayberries, bearberries, northern honeysuckle, pale laurel, and blueberries. Rare and protected species of wildflowers such as moccasin flower and yellow clintonia are also found there. But most abundant and most notable of all of the plant life on the island are those which give the island its name, the mosses. The island is called Moss Island, and there are perhaps five varieties of mosses living and thriving on the rocks and shallow acidic soils of the island's eastern end. Equally important are the geological phenomenon called potholes, which occur on the island's northeastern edge. Potholes are naturally drilled holes in rock, which are drilled by the grinding action of loose stones swirled about in a vortex of water produced by a falls. Potholes found under falls such as Niagara would probably be 4 feet across and 5 feet deep. Moss islands range from a few inches to 20 feet or more in depth, from half a foot to 10 and 12 feet in width. The island also has strong artistic value. Professor Pribble of Monser Proctor Institute of Art in Utica commented that the mosses lend the island an unusual quality. The tupelo trees are unusual, and their multicolored leaves in the fall lend almost the character of an oriental landscape. For many years, Moss Island has been regarded as a potential park area by conservation and recreation-minded people, not only in Little Falls, but in the whole Herkimer County area. Hundreds of people currently come every year to view the island and enjoy its scenic beauty. Efforts to secure Moss Island as a park have been made for many years, but progress has been slow. Moss Island is an extremely excellent recreational area. Its relation to the canal and its beauty make it an excellent place for the location of marina and docking facilities for recreational boat traffic. There are no other such facilities close by the Little Falls area. This also would encourage fishing, especially with the continuing improvement of water quality through the newly constructed local water treatment facility. Thank you. a problem, though, in this excellent recreational picture. In recent years, the city's plans have taken a new turn with regard to the island. Beginning in 1958, after the opening of the New York State Thruway, the city of Little Falls began looking at Moss Island not as the excellent recreational area that it is, but simply as a place across which to build a bridge to connect the city with Thruway Exit 29A, a project which would destroy much of the beauty and the park value of the island. This project, as it is proposed, will cost over $5.5 million using state and federal funds. City officials seem to believe that this connection would be the economic salvation of the city of Little Falls. They have linked the project with the laying down of a downtown expressway and an industrial park and an urban renewal project. But this thruway connection would destroy the potentially good economic drawing card for the Little Falls community, and this does not need to happen. The thruway connection could easily be relocated to a nearby route, completely avoiding the island. Such a relocation would be extremely desirable, for not only would it preserve the island, its beauty, its recreational value, but Department of Transportation cost estimates show that it would perhaps cost $3 million less than the currently proposed route and be less troublesome to build. There is no good reason why the route cannot or should not be changed. Little Falls is a city with possibilities of a bright future, but it must be a well-planned future. The city must be in step with the latest developments in community planning. It must be aware of the value of recreational sites, in tune to the need for urban open space. It must reflect the growing environmental consciousness of a nation that for too long has raped the land upon which it was built. The area along the Mohawk River, particularly regarding the thruway connection and Moss Island, is just such a place where this kind of planning is called for. Not short-sighted planning, seeing only the immediate economic factors involved, but far-reaching planning, incorporating the economic, social, and environmental costs of development. Rerouting the thruway connection and developing Moss Island's park and recreation potential is just such planning. This is what Little Falls needs for full development of its available resources in rebuilding its community and capturing the vision of a bright future.